So we are discussing structural engineering to design of steel structures. So in that we have seen the introduction topics, right? So that is, what is steel, how it is manufactured, properties of steel, types of structural steels, advantages, disadvantages, mechanical property, physical properties of the structural steels. And we have seen the loads, the design requirements, loads and load combinations, and design methods, working stress, ultimate load method, and limit state design concepts. We have seen the previous classes. So today we will see the connections, right? Connections. So what do you mean by connections? Okay, you know very well that any steel structure is an assemblage of different members and elements. The various elements of a steel structure, like tension member, compression member, and flexural member, are connected by means of fasteners, that is connectors. So many times built-up sections and plate girders are provided to meet the requirements of heavy loads and long spans. Such sections also need to be connected together to act as a one unit. So further, the length of the member may be more than the length of the section available. So the length of the member required may be more than the length of the section available. So, and this will also necessitate the connections of the two lengths to make up the required length. So, generally, whenever we join the two elements, okay, tension member, compression, flexural members, we need to provide the connectors. For built-up section, plate girder, that type of structures, we need connections. And when the required length will be very less than the available length, we need to connect two or three length of the member, but then we need to provide the connections. So this is the image of connections. You can see this is the column, compression member. This is the beam, flexural member, so connected by means of the bolted connections. This is called connections or the joints. These connectors may be the bolted, riveter, or welded. Here it is bolted connections. So the forces exerted by one element on another are transferred through these fasteners. So fastener means either bolting, riveting, welding. So which would therefore be adequate to transmit the forces safely. So only properly connected and detailed members and the connections can be transferred the forces safely from the top of the structure to the foundation. So different types of the connectors, different types of the fasteners available for making the connections are riveted, bolted, pin, and welded connections. So today steel structures are constructed with the bolting, that is ordinary bolted connections or high strength bolted connections, or welding, or by combination of the bolted and welded connections. Earlier riveted connections are nowadays that is obsolete. So in the past couple of decades, high strength bolts have become more popular. It is replaced to riveted connections. Okay, so most of the failure of the steel structure in past have revealed that connections are the weakest link in the structure. So generally in the structure, the connections are the weakest section. So we have to take care of the connection design. Therefore, the design of connection must be very, very important. The ultimate aim of the connection design is to produce a joint that is simple and compatible, feasible, easy to fabricate, and it should be safe and economical. So the aim of the connection is to produce a joint that should be simple connection, compatible connection, and it should be feasible and easy to fabricate, and it should be safety as well as economical. So the types of connections, the connections may be classified according to the following parameters. one is method of fastening, such as reverse bolts and welding. And second one is connection rigidity, based on the rigidity, simple connection, rigid connections, and semi-rigid connections. And based on joint resistance, bearing connections, and friction connections. Based on fabrication location, shop connections, and field connections. Based on joint location, beam column connection, beam to beam connections, and column to foundation connections. Then based on connection geometry, such as single web angle, single plate, double web angle, etc. And types of forces transferred across the structural connections, based on the types of force transferred through the structural connections, shear and moment connection, moment twisting connections, etc. Okay. So these are all the types of connections based on the various parameters. And connection based on method of fastening. So riveted connection, bolted connections, welded connections. As we said earlier, this is obsolete. So bolted and welded are the major concentration. So bolted connections. A bolt may be defined as a metal pin with a head. This is the head. With a head at the one end and the shank. So this is the shank. Shank and threaded at the other end. So one end. Okay, head and another end, shank threaded. Okay, the other end to receive the fish nut. So steel washers are usually provided. So this is the steel washers are usually provided under the bolts as well as under the nut to serve two purposes. One is to distribute the clamping pressure on the bolted member and to prevent the threaded portion of the bolt from bearing on the connecting piece. So for that purpose, we are providing the steel washer. Bolts can be used for making end connection in tension and compression members and in fabrication of built-up and compound members, as we said earlier. So they can also be used to hold down the column bases in positioning, joining column caps with the shoe plates of trusses and as separators for purlin in trusses and beams in the foundations. So bolts can be used for the making connection of like these tension members, compression members, built-up members, foundation, all of this. Okay. So what are the advantages of bolted connections? So the joints can be made without noise. Okay. So there is no any noise when they are doing the bolted connections. Skilled labor is not needed. We don't need much skilled labor. Less labor is enough. Complete the process. Quick connections can be made and structure can be immediately put into use after the connection. And it accommodates minor variations in dimensions. Alterations can be accommodated easily. Working area required in the field is very less. So these are all the advantages of bolted connections. So disadvantages of bolted connections. There is a considerable reduction in tensile strength. So because of the additional bolt is connected, so because of the stress concentration, the strength will be reduced. Okay, so tensile strength will be reduced. And rigidity of joints is reduced due to loose fit. So if you are not fit properly, the rigidity also loss. And due to vibration, nuts are likely to loosen. So in case of vibrations and all, there is a possibility of loosening the nuts. These are the disadvantages. And types of bolts, commonly used bolts are unfinished bolts, high strength bolt. There are two types of bolts which are used commonly. One is unfinished bolts, another one is high strength bolt. Unfinished bolt. Unfinished bolts are also called as ordinary bolt or common bolt or rough bolt or black bolts. Another name of unfinished bolts are ordinary bolt, common bolt, rough bolt, black bolt. So these are used for lightweight structures subjected to static loads and for secondary members such as purlin, brazing, and roof trusses, etc. So in the case of lightweight structures, secondary members, we can use this type of unfinished bolt, ordinary bolts. They are not recommended for the connection subjected to heavy loads, impact loads, vibrations, and fatigue loads. And types of ordinary black bolts,
generally it is made from the mild steel with a square or hexagonal head. The bolts are available from 5 to 36 mm in diameter and are designated as M5 to M36. So most commonly used black bolts are M16, M20, M24 and M30. These are all the most common, M5 to M36, but M16, M20, M24 and M30 is the most common used. The ratio of net tensile area at the thread to the nominal plane shank area of the bolt is 0.78. So generally see, this is the shank, this is plane shank area. So this is pi d square by 4. But if it is the threaded, threaded means some area is reduced because of this threading. So the net area which is equal to 0.78 times the shank area. Okay, so A net is equal to 0.78 times A is the shank area. So the bolt hole is punctually about 1.6 mm more than the bolt diameter. Generally, the bolts of property class 4.6 and 8.8 are available. The ultimate tensile strength of class 4.6 bolt is, suppose 4.6 is the class bolt. 4.6 bolt means 400 Nm² is the ultimate tensile strength. This 0.6 into 400 is the 250 yield strength of the 4.6 class bolts. So 0.6 times 400, we will get 240 is the yield strength. 400, we will get the ultimate strength 400. Normally for ordinary bolted joints, the load or the force is transferred to the interlocking and bearing of the bolt, and the joint is called bearing type joints. So ordinary blank bolts, one, the load is transferred through the interlocking and bearing of the bolts. Therefore, it is called bearing type joints. Now we can see the high strength bolt. Second type of bolt is high strength bolt. So the high strength bolts are made from the bars of medium carbon heat treated steel and from alloy steel. This permit load to be transferred primarily by the means of friction and not by shear. So in the black bolts, it is transferred by means of shear and bearing. But in the case of friction, high strength bolts, the load is transferred by means of friction. So it is called friction type bolt. So high strength bolt is also called friction type bolt. Due to this friction, the slip in the joint is eliminated. There is no slip. Therefore, non-slip connection. So it is also called as friction type connections. There is no slip. There is no shear and bearing. Therefore, this is non-slip connection. High strength bolted connection is there. Also called as friction type connections or non-slip connection. Okay. So the high strength bolts are available in the sizes from 16 to 36 mm and are designated as M16, M20, M24 and M30, M36 like that. The bolts of property class 8S, 8.8S, 10S or 10.9S are available. S stands for high strength. The most commonly used bolts are 8.8S and 10.9S property class. The specification for high strength bolts are prepared from these bolts IS 3757-1985 and IS 4000-1992. So it is used in structure like high raised buildings, bridges, machines, etc. Okay, so advantages of high strength bolt. So HSFG, high strength friction grip. HSFG stands for high strength friction grip bolts, provides a rigid joint. There is no slip between the elements connected, as we said earlier. So large tensile stresses are developed in the bolt, which in turn provide large clamping forces. So load is transferred by means of friction only because of the clamping action, and the bolts are not subjected to any shearing and bearing. So failure at the net section is minimized because frictional resistance is effective outside the bolt. So at the net section, the failure will be minimized because of the effectiveness of the bolt, frictional resistance. So there is no stress concentration in the hole, and therefore the fatigue strength is more. There is no stress concentration So the fitting strength is more. The tension in the bolt is uniform. The few persons are required to make the connection. The cost is also reduced. Noise nuisance is not there. Alteration can be done easily. For same strength, lesser number of bolts are required as compared to ordinary bolts, which will be overall economical. So when you use the black bolt, you should use more number of bolts. But for the same strength, when you use the high strength bolt, lesser number is enough. Therefore, this economical. And coming to the types of bolted joints, lap joint and the butt joint. So lap joint means overlapping. So one member, so another member is overlapping. Okay. So one member connected to the another member. So butt joint means two members to be connected or placed end to end. Suppose. So this is butt joint. This is one member. This is another member. So here you can see this is one member. This is another member. These two members are connected by means of this member. So this is called butt joint. Okay. So here you can see single cover butt joint. Suppose this is one member. This is one member. This is connected by means of this only one cover plate and the top. Single cover butt joint. So in the single cover butt joint, single cover, single bolted butt joint. That means can be this is medial section. If you take left side or right side, so this is only one row, or let's say one column. Only one column, the bolt is connected. Therefore, single cover, single bolted butt joint. So this is single bolted butt joint. So only one cover plate on the top. Therefore, single cover. Only one column. Bolted bolt, that is single bolted bolt. Single cover, double bolted bolt. So here you can see single cover. So this two plate connected by only one plate, single cover. But two bolts, okay? Two bolted line, two columns. Therefore, double bolted bolt. So single cover, double bolted bolt. Here you can see double cover, single bolted bolt. Double cover. It means this is two member. Connected by means of top cover plate and bottom also cover plate is there, but it is connected by means of only one bolted line. So double cover, single bolted butt joint. Double cover, double bolted butt joint means, see this is two member connected by top plate, bottom plate. So two double cover and double bolted line. So double bolted joints. So double cover, double. Bolted butt joint. So lap joint means this is one plate, another plate is overlapped by means of bolted joints. Butt joint means two plate connected by means of the cover plate. That is called butt joint. Either single cover butt joint or double cover butt joint. So behavior of the bolted joints. So depending on the types of connections and the loads, bolts are subjected to the following types of load transfer. Either single shear, that is only one plane subjected to shear, or double shear, two planes subjected to shear, or pure shear, only shear except moment, or pure moment, only moment except shear, shear and moment in the plane of connection, shear and tension. Okay. So failure of the bolted joints, so shear failure of bolts, bearing failure of bolts, bearing failure of plates, tension failure of the bolts, tension or tearing failure of plates, and black shear. So these are the failure of bolted joints. Okay. So these are shear failures. Single shear. So only one plane subjected to failure. This is double shear. Here one plane, here also one plane. Two plane subjected to shearing failure. So what is shear? So when the force is acting, it is broken into two pieces. Two pieces. Shear failure. So due to the application of forces, the plates slip and generate shear stresses. The maximum factored shear force in the bolt may exceed the nominal shear capacity. When the shear capacity, the forces exceed the shear capacity of the bolt, the failure will occur. The shear failure occurs at the best shear plane, and bolts may fail in the single or double shear. Single or double shear. So that is called shear failure of the bolt. Bearing failure of the bolt. The bolt is crushed around the circumferences of the bolt. So bearing failure generally occur except when plates are made of high strength steel. Okay. So bearing failure of plates. So this type of failure occurs when the plate material is weaker than the bolt material. When the plate material is weaker than the bolt material, then the plate will be failure. Okay, that is called bearing failure of the plate. Tension failure of the bolt. The bolt subjected to tension may fail at the stress area. That is called tension failure. Tension failure of the plate. So when the bolts are stronger than the plate, then the tearing or tension failure of the plate will be occur. Okay, if the bolt strength is more than the plate strength, that case tension failure plate will be occur. And black shear failure. The bolts are possible to get sheared when the bolts are placed at the lesser end distance. Suppose here. Without giving any much end distance, if you provide these connections, here you can see one black itself coming out from this as a plate. So this is the plate, here the connections are provided. So some black, some portion tear out from the plate. This is the black shear failure. Okay, so these are all the types of failure. Of the bolted joints, shear failure, bearing failure of the bolts, bearing failure of the plate, tension failure of the bolt, tension failure of the plate, black shear failure. Specifications of the bolted joint. Coming to the specifications of the bolted joints. So first we will see diameter of the bolt. So in general, a connection with a few large diameter bolts cost less than one of the same capacity with many small diameter bolts. Suppose we need to carry 400 kN. For that 400 kN, instead of providing the small number of 10 bolts, if you provide 6 number of large bolts, large sized bolts, then it will be economical because the fewer the bolts, the fewer number of bolts to be formed and the less installation work. No need to provide more number of bolts. So installation will be very less when you consider the large size. And the pitch, so it is the distance between the center of two consecutive bolts measured along the row of the bolt, horizontal direction, when the force is acting on the direction, in that direction, horizontal direction. If you measure the distance between two consecutive bolts, that is called pitch. So for wide plates, pitch may also be defined as the center to center distance of bolts measured along the length of the member of the connection. So along the length of the member, center to center distance between the bolts is called a pitch. So when the bolts are placed staggered, suppose inclined, staggered means zigzag, inclined, then it is called the distance between the inclined distance between these two pitch is called the staggered pitch. And minimum pitch, the distance between the center of bolts should not be less than 2.5 times the nominal diameter of the bolt. So minimum pitch will be is equal to 2.5 times D, where D is the nominal diameter of the bolt. Maximum pitch, which is equal to 32 times thickness or 300 mm. The limits based on maximum pitch in various cases are as follows. So generally the distance between the center of two consecutive bolts in the direction of stress should not exceed its pitch. Pitch value should not exceed 16 times D or 200 mm, whichever is less in the case of tension number. Suppose if you are using tension number, the maximum pitch should not exceed 16T or 200 mm. In the case of compression number, the maximum pitch will be about 12 times thickness of 200 mm. For the compression number means 12T or 200 mm. Tension means 16T or 200 mm maximum pitch. So minimum pitch 2.5 times B. B is the nominal gauge. Gauge means opposite to pitch. Suppose pitch is along the x direction, horizontal direction, or length direction, or force direction. Then gauge is the vertical direction, right angles, so vertical direction. We measure the distance between two bolts along the vertical direction, then it is called gauge. And edge distance is nothing but the distance at the right angles to the direction of stress from the center of the bolt hole to the adjacent edge of the member. Let's see this figure. So here, so this is the force direction or length of the member horizontal direction. So the distance between two consecutive bolts is called pitch. And vertical direction, if you measure the distance between two consecutive bolts, this is called gauge. And end distance means the distance between the end of the member to the center of the bolt hole in the edge direction. And edge distance means the distance between the center of the bolt to the end of the member in the vertical direction. And so this is the nominal diameter of the bolt hole. For that, how much the bolt hole clearance, okay, how much we have to give here. So 12 mm bolt is the D, means the diameter of the hole DH or D naught will be 13 mm, 1 mm increased. So up to 12 mm and 14 mm, 1 mm increase. Here you can see 16 mm, 18 mm, 20 mm, 22 mm, 24 mm and all, 2 mm increase. So 16 means the bolt hole is 18. 18 means 20, 20 means 22, 22 means 24, 24 means 26. Suppose 27 mm is the nominal diameter, the bolt hole is 30 mm. 30 mm is the nominal diameter, the bolt hole is 33 mm. And above 36 means the bolt diameter plus 33 mm we have to add. And minimum edge distance also, for sheared or rough edge, they are given the edge distance. And for rolled or planed edge also, they are given edge distance. So minimum pitch, maximum pitch, we discussed already. Okay. So this is the introduction about the connections. So next class we will see design of bolted joints. Okay. Thank you all.